وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى this is going to be our eighth wasiyah, and it is at-tawbah an-nasuh, repentance. My beloved brother and sister, after inshallah listening to these words bi-idhnillahi al-kareem and some of the statements and the evidence that I will provide, I hope inshallah ta'ala that it will push you to make the decision to repent, to return and run back to your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ila ar-rahim al-ghaffar, the most merciful, the forgiving, the one who said fafirru ila Allah, to Allah run. My beloved brother and sister, al-awbah al-awbah, repentance, return back to your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the door is locked on you. Before the door is not just closed, but it's locked on you and you can't enter. Before there is a veil placed before you and repentance. Repent to your Lord. Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. The ones who repent and come with righteous actions, they are the ones who are going to enter Jannah. They will never be oppressed. Allah will not oppress them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If any one of you say, I have sinned, I have done so many mistakes, I have gone out of my limits, I have done things that I don't think Allah will ever forgive me, I want to say to you, that is the whispers of shaitan. There is not a crime, however big you think that crime is, the forgiveness of your Lord is greater and bigger. Your sins that you do in this dunya, it can never be bigger than the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen to the speech of your Lord towards you. قال تعالى, Allah says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. قُلْ سَيِّدَ مُحَمَّدٍ, Ya ibadi, my slaves, alladhina asrafu, those who've exceeded their limits, those who have done so much bad things, la taqnatu, don't give up. From what? Min rahmatillah, forgiveness of your Lord, the mercy of your Lord, don't give up. Inna Allah yaghfiru adh-dhunuba jami'a, Allah forgives all sins. Innahu huwa al-ghafuru al-rahim, verily Allah is the forgiving and most merciful. People might say to you, you did this and this and I can't believe you anymore, or you're evil and I always would consider you to be a bad person. That is a person but not the creator. That is the created, not the creator. The creator forgives everything. Oh, you who's listening, the one who's talking to you, which is myself, Abdul Rahman, and all of the children of Adam, we all do sins. Ay na'am wallah. We do sins. We sin. We go against Allah's commands. We do what He told us not to do. We fall short in our obligations. And we always ask him for forgiveness, beg him. We don't give up on his mercy. We say, Ya Rab, I am sinning. I did this mistake. I did this. Forgive me, my Lord. And we hope from him that he forgives us. We are all in it together. So join us in asking Allah for forgiveness. The poet, he said, وَمِمَّا زَادَنِي شَرَفًا وَتِيهًا وَكِدْتُ بِأَخْمُصِي أَطَأُ الثُّرَيَّ دُخُولِيَ تَحْتَ قَوْلِكَ يَا عِبَادِي وَأَنْ سَيَّرْتَ أَحْمَدَ لِي نَبِيًّا. What increases me in happiness and honor is that at a time when I'm sinning and I'm falling short in my obligations and I'm doing what I was told not to do, Allah refers to me as Ya Ibadi, my slaves. Allah attributes himself to me, attributes himself, I mean, he attributes us to him. That really brings happiness to me, wallah. That brings joy to me. He's referring to me as Ya Ibadi, my slave. And I am sinning. I am going against his commands. I am doing what he told me not to do, clearly and explicitly. And he's saying to me, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Don't give up on the mercy of your Lord. That is مِمَّا زَادَنِي شَرَفًا وَتِيهًا. This increases me in honor, happiness and joy. Allah is happy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It brings joy to Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. Lallahu afrahu bitawbati abdihi. Allah is more happier with the repentance of his slave, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It brings happiness to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what? Then a man who's in the desert. This man is in the middle of the desert. And then on this, in the desert that he's in, he has a riding beast. And in that ride, on that riding beast, there's drink and there's water. And there's food as well. So there's water and there is food and all his belongings are on this riding beast. And his riding beast gets lost. And he wakes up and he doesn't have anything. He gets ready for death. And as he's preparing for death, he goes to sleep and he wakes up and then he guesses what he sees. Standing at his head, he sees his riding beast with all of his belongings on it. Pay attention here. What is the happiness that that slave is going to feel? How happy will that slave feel? It's like he's being given a second life. Allah is more happier than that slave at that moment, the way he feels. How can we then not be willing to ask Allah for forgiveness? The Prophet told us, alayhi salam, in Hadith Qudsi, known as Hadith al-Ilahi, Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in Sahih, in his Jami'ah, in Hadith Anas ibn Malik. Anas ibn Malik, he said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ. I heard the Prophet saying, قَالَ اللَّهُ, Allah saying, يَبْنَ آدَمْ, the children of Adam, مَا دَعَوْتَنِي, إِنَّكَ مَا دَعَوْتَنِي وَرَجَوْتَنِي غَفَرْتُ لَكَ مَا كَانَ فِيكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. That there is no sin that you do, the children of Adam, except that Allah said, I will forgive you for all of those sins. يَبْنَ آدَمْ, the children of Adam, لَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ, your sins, if it piles up and it reaches the sky, ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي, and then you asked Allah for forgiveness, Allah is saying, غَفَرْتُ لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. Allah will forgive you for your sins. يَبْنَ آدَمْ, the children of Adam, لَوْ أَتَيْتَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَا, if you come to me, this earth full of sins, ثُمَّ لَقِيْتَنِي, but you also come with no shirk involved. لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا, you don't associate partners with Allah. لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرَةً Allah will give you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgiveness and all of that. All of your sins, Allah will change it for you for mercy and forgiveness. This doesn't mean go and do all the sins out there. No, it doesn't. But it means that when you do sin, don't give up. Ask Allah for forgiveness. After trying and exerting the effort to not want to do that sin, remember that He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will forgive you if you repent. That's what the message is. The poet, he said, وَلَمَّا قَسَى قَلْبِي وَضَاقَتْ مَذَاهِبِي جعلت الرجاء مني لعفوك سلما تعاظمني ذنبي فلما قرنته بعفوك ربي كان عفوك أعظما. The poet is saying, ولما قسى قلبي, when my heart became tainted, وضاقت مذاهبي, and my مذاهب, and it became ضيق. جعلت الرجاء, I placed my رجاء, my hope in Allah تبارك وتعالى. جعلت الرجاء مني لعفوك سلما, I placed my hope in your forgiveness. تعاظمني ذنبي, my sins seemed to be so much to me. I saw my sins to be so big. فلما قرنته, but when I placed my sins بعفوك, I placed it next to your forgiveness, sir. What happened? كَانَ عَفُوكَ عَظَمًا. I realized that your forgiveness is greater than my sins. One of the conditions of repentance, or the conditions, or the three conditions of repentance is أَنْ يُقْلِعَ عَنِ الْمَعْصِيَةِ. You have to leave the sin, my sister, my brother. The second thing is أَنْ يَنْدَمَ عَلَى فِعْلِهَا. You have to regret the action that you did. You can't be laughing about it. And the third one is أَنْ يَعْزِمَ أَلَّا يَعُودَ إِلَيْهَا أَبَدًا. The person has to make the decision that they will never ever go and do this sin again. فَإِنْ فُقِدَ أَحَدُ الثَّلَاثَةِ. If any of those three conditions are missing, لَمْ تَصِحَ تَوْبَتُهُ, your tawbah will not be accepted. And if it is, وَإِنْ كَانَتِ الْمَعْصِيَةُ تَتَعَلَّقُ بِآدَمِي, if it's someone's rights that you've taken, then there's a fourth condition. فَشُرُوطُهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ. The first three, and on top of that, a fourth one. Which is what? أَنْ يَبْرَأَ مِنْ حَقِّ صَاحِبِهَا. You have to free yourself from that person's rights. فَإِنْ كَانَتْ مَالًا, if it's wealth, if it's money that you've taken, أَوْ نَحْوَهُ رَدَّهُ إِلَيْهِ, you have to return it back to him. وَإِنْ كَانَ حد قذف, if you've slandered him, then you have to be lashed for it. وإن كانت غيبة استحله منها, if it's backbiting that you've done, you have to go to that person and tell them to forgive you. And Imam al-Nawawi talks about this in great details in his Kitab Riyadu al-Salihin. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives us for our sins. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.